you know what the bad guys are doing? How would you find out or describe how a cyber attack was performed? You need a common language, a framework for describing a cyber attack, a Bible that everyone can read from. Luckily, we have one, and it's called the MITRE Attack Matrix. You need to know how to use it, and I'm going to show you. Let's jump in. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Adam, and this channel is all about cyber threat intelligence. I've built CTI teams and trained clients to effectively use CTI in their daily work. If you want to learn it all for free, subscribe to this channel. The MITRE Attack Matrix is the holy bible of cyber threat intelligence. It provides a common language for describing and categorizing adversarial tactics, techniques, and procedures, or TTPs. And it's based on real-world observations. Let's jump into it and explore it in detail so you can start using it in your work. The MITRE Attack Matrix is used to analyze and understand the tactics and techniques that a threat actor will use to compromise, infiltrate, and exfiltrate information from a system or network. It consists of a matrix that lists various tactics and techniques used by attackers, like initial access, persistence, privilege escalation, and exfiltration. In recent years, the initial matrix has been separated into three matrices that cover enterprises, mobiles, and industrial control systems. There is even a matrix for attacks on artificial intelligence and large language models called MITRE ATT&CK. These matrices list the specific TTPs threat actors will use in each specific domain. We will focus on the enterprise version of the framework because it is the most widely used by security professionals to assess and evaluate their organization's defenses and then identify areas that need improvement. By understanding the specific tactics and techniques used by attackers, defenders can take proactive measures to improve their security posture and mitigate potential threats before they even happen. As a cyber threat intelligence analyst, the MITRE Attack Framework is an indispensable tool. It allows you to collaborate within the industry when reacting to common threats. If ABC Security provides managed security services to several organizations, and they see that a threat actor is targeting several of these organizations using similar TTPs, they will often share the TTPs used by this threat actor to the wider community. Then the security team at XYZ Corporation can use this information to perform threat hunting, confirm if they have detection capabilities related to these TTPs, and ultimately be better protected by taking proactive measures. The MITRE Attack Matrix acts as a common language that ABC can share these TTPs so XYZ can protect themselves. I'm curious though, do you already know about the MITRE Attack Matrix? Do you use it in your daily work? I'd love to hear the answers in the comments. Now that you have an understanding of what the MITRE Attack Framework is and how it can be used, let's jump into the technical details so you can begin using the framework yourself. The MITRE Attack Framework is comprehensive and provides detailed knowledge of adversarial tactics and techniques. These tactics and techniques are divided into an organizational structure. We have tactics at the top, and then each tactic will have techniques and sub-techniques that are grouped underneath them. Under these techniques, you have procedures, which are the specific actions required to perform that technique. A tactic is a high-level goal or objective that an attacker aims to achieve during a cyber attack. It encompasses a broad range of techniques and procedures that attackers may use to accomplish their objectives. A technique is a specific method or approach that an attacker may use to accomplish that specific goal or objective, as defined by the tactic. The tactics in the framework stay consistent. However, as new hacking methods emerge, the techniques are regularly updated between different versions of the framework. The 14 tactics that you need to know are as follows. First, we have reconnaissance, These are techniques that involve adversaries actively or passively gathering information that can be used to support targeting victims, such as scanning for vulnerabilities or phishing for information about the technologies or people an organization employs. Next, we have resource development. These are techniques that involve adversaries creating, purchasing, or compromising and stealing resources that can be used to support targeting victims. These resources could be infrastructure, accounts, or capabilities. Think about malware, ransomware, or crafting a phishing email. Then we have initial access. These are techniques used to gain an initial foothold in a system or network, like exploiting vulnerabilities or using social engineering to have an employee execute malicious software on their system. Then we have execution. These are techniques used to execute malicious code on a system, like running a script or installing malware. Once the malware has been installed, we can move to persistence. These techniques are used to maintain access to the compromised system or network for a longer period of time, like creating a backdoor or installing a rootkit. Next, adversaries will look to escalate their privileges with privilege escalation techniques. These allow them to gain a higher level of access on a system or network, and could include exploiting vulnerabilities in an operating system or applications so they can gain admin privileges. Then we have the defense evasion techniques. These are used to evade detection by security controls like antivirus software or intrusion detection systems. Next up, we have credential access techniques. These are used to steal or crack credentials, such as stealing a password or exploiting vulnerabilities in authentication mechanisms like Kerberos. Then we have discovery. These techniques allow attackers to gather information about a system or network, like enumerating user accounts or scanning for open ports. They'll use this information to move on to perform lateral movement in the target environment. These techniques are used to move laterally through a network, like stealing credentials to access other systems or using remote desktop protocols. This lets adversaries find more valuable targets and achieve their objectives. Then we have collection. These techniques are used to collect data or information from a system or network once it's been compromised. These include exfiltrating sensitive data or capturing keystrokes. Once an adversary has this sensitive data, they'll then try to exfiltrate it, usually through command and control. These techniques allow an adversary to communicate with the systems under their control from within the victim network. Adversaries will try to mimic normal traffic to blend into their target environment and avoid detection. Then we move to exfiltration. These techniques are used to transfer data or information out of a system or network, like using a command and control channel or using cloud storage services to blend in to regular traffic. Then finally, we have impact. These techniques are used by adversaries to disrupt the availability or compromise the integrity of information by manipulating business and operational processes. This usually involves destroying or tampering with data. Think about ransomware encrypting for impact. The technical details for each tactic and technique include information about the attack vector, the type of software or tool used, and the potential impact to the system or network. This information is designed to help defenders understand the threat landscape and develop effective mitigation strategies. In fact, you can use the MITRE Defend project to jump straight from a TTP to a mitigation strategy. Organizations and security platforms will publish threat intelligence reports that detail security incidents. In these reports, they usually list the TTPs the security team observed when investigating the incident, and the team will detail these using the MITRE ATT&CK framework. You, as a defender, reading the report, can then research this technique using the MITRE ATT&CK framework and find specific mitigations or ways of detecting this technique. That's it. The flow of threat intelligence to operational security. You read threat intelligence reports, Use a MITRE ATT&CK framework to check you have the appropriate mitigations and detections in place, and then rest easy. The hard part is having the mitigations in place and keeping up with the latest threats. But this general flow is how most security teams improve their defenses on a continual basis and keep up to date with what threat actors are doing. The MITRE ATT&CK framework is a fundamental tool in your cybersecurity arsenal. It provides a common language for describing and categorizing adversarial tactics, techniques, and procedures based on real-world observations. It has become the Bible of cyber threat intelligence and is widely used in the industry for describing TTPs. Now you know what it is and how to use it, start looking for mentions of the framework in the cyber threat intelligence reports you use and integrate it with your reporting. If you enjoyed this video, please give a like to let me know you want to see more of this content and stay tuned for more deep dives into key cyber threat intelligence tools, technologies, and frameworks. I'll see you soon.